beer connoisseurs gather for the SIBA Southeast competition, held in Tunbridge. The judges will sample between them 153 cask ales and 54 bottled beers to find their champion brewers for 2011.
We split our real ale competition into 8 categories of beer, allocate our judges to different tables, and they judge these categories. They test the aroma of the beer and they taste the beer. It's not in any way a pretentious process though, because they're all ordinary folk, some punters from pubs, some pub landlords, and they're effectively using the guidance of the judging sheet, the categories, the criteria of judging, to decide for themselves which is their favourite beer.
For me, how it circulates around the mouth and the different taste sensations you get through the mouthful. I was also looking for the aftertaste, in whether it lingers, whether it disappears, whether you've forgotten what you just drunk, or whether you really want to kind of have another bash at it, have another taste, I think.
I've had 2 or 3 which I wasn't very happy with, but out of 20 beers, I would think 16, 17 have been of good quality.
I think when you end up in a bar later on tonight, you'll do exactly the same thing and you'll be comparing one with the other. So no, absolutely, it's an education in itself.
Entries are from breweries of all sizes and ages, although many of SIBA's newest members have been founded in the last decade.
They're engaging in an ancient craft, and they are coincidentally and fortuitously ticking a lot of relevant boxes for people's purchasing habits these days. You've now got very, very interesting beers that belie the old image of the beer-bellied, bearded, stereotypical beer drinker like I am. And we've now got a much more interest among young people and among women, because beer has become very interesting and maybe just even a little bit cool.
After 2 rounds of judging, the beers are whittled down to a shortlist for 1 final round of tasting. Gold winners of the 5 bottled beer categories then compete for the overall award, won by Kent's largest microbrewery.
It's Viceroy India Pale Ale from the Western Brewery.
This beer's been made with hops that we planted at Scotney Castle just 3 years ago, and they've slowly matured and now they've come to, you know, being fantastic hops, and I'm really pleased for Ian, who grows the hops at Scotney Castle.
And out of the 8 categories of cask ale, the overall winner is
Whitstable Brewery for Native.
A lot of breweries are doing better and better, and to win amongst all these fantastic brewers is a great, great achievement, I think.
A long day for the judges draws to a close, but for the winners of the Southeast competition, they're through to the national final, to be held next March.